Students, this is the revision video for your second unit test. The portion plan for social science is Chapter 1, Rajput Age, New Ruler and States, Chapter 2, The Delhi Sultanate, and Chapter 3, Mughal Empire. Now let's have a look at the paper style. Your exam is going to be of 25 marks, so the question pattern will be Question 1, find the correct option and write the correct answer, that is MCQs for 5 marks. There will be 5 MCQ, 1 mark each. Second, fill in the blanks for 6 marks. Again, 6 blanks, 1 mark each. Question 3, state whether the following sentences are true or false, 5 marks. Objective question, in all of these, you just have to write the correct answers. And all of them carry 1 mark each. And question 4 is write short notes on the following. It is of 9 marks. You will be asked 3 short notes. Each short note carries 3 marks. So students, as we have already studied the chapters, we have completed the tests. For revision, I am not explaining it once again, or I am not giving you the examples of which kind of MCQs or which kind of blanks can be asked. We have done that during live classes. So now we'll be focusing on short notes. Which kind of questions can be asked for short notes? So here I have covered all the short notes from these three chapters and we'll be studying them. Here I have also highlighted the main points. So if you remember the points, you can remember the short note easily. So let's start with that. The first short note is Characteristics of Rajputs from Chapter 1. Rajputs were brave, so their reign lasted long. They kept their promises even at the cost of their lives. They would rather die than show their back to the enemy. They were protectors of Gau Brahmins. They would protect the surrendered at any cost. They never practiced unrighteousness even in the battle. Rajput women were famous for their valor. They sent their sons and husbands to the war front happily. They didn't even care for their safety and security. If needed, they would go out in the battlefield with sword in their hand. So here, while writing, you do not have to underline the points. This is just for your, so that you can easily remember it. So one type of question can be characteristics of Rajputs. You can either write in paragraph style or with points, whichever you are comfortable with. But make sure that everything is covered because it is a 3-mark question. Next question or short note can be trade and commerce during the Rajput era. There was a separate department for taking care of commerce related matters in the Rajput era. This department used to make arrangement for collection of tax over foreign trade, decide the value of things and purchase essential commodities required in the state. Main source of tax collection was land revenue, which was 1/6 part of the production. In Rajput era, land tax was known as Bhag. Revenue was also collected from ports, check posts and irrigation. Stambh Tirth, Khambhat and Bhrigu Kach, Bharuch ports of Gujarat, were famous for foreign trade at that time. Question 3. Describe the architecture of Sultanate period. This is from Chapter 2. The architecture of Sultanate period was of Indo-Islamic style. During the Sultanate period, significant works of architecture like forts, mosques, tombs, houses, gardens, gates, minarets, etc. were constructed. During the reign of Qutbuddin Aibak, a mosque named Quwwat-ul-Islam, Delhi, Qutb Minar, Delhi, and Dhai Din Ka Jhopra, Ajmer, were built. The construction during the period of Iltutmish include Hoz-e-Shammi, Shammi-Idga and Jama Masjid. Major construction work during the reign of Alauddin Khilji include Alai Darwaza, Siri Fort and a town named Siri and Hoz-e-Khas. Bandi Khan's Dome, Bada Gumbaj, Mott's Mosque and Shihabuddin's tomb were the major tombs and mosques built during the Sayyid and Lodi dynasty. Next question, give brief information about Krishna Dev Rai. Krishna Dev Rai was the best ruler of Tulwa dynasty of Vijayanagar Empire. He won many battles during his reign and never neglected the administration. He got lakes and canals dug in the state to enrich agriculture and abolished some unjust taxes. He established a town named Nagalpur near Vijayanagar and decorated it with various buildings and temples. He was a great scholar and wrote several texts in Sanskrit and Telugu. Due to the spread of literary art, he became well known as the Bhoj of Andhra. Question 5. Give the outline of Mughal administration. The Mughal administration was systematically established by Akbar. In it, the emperor was the center of the rule and head of the council of ministers. He was the supreme commander and judge. A vizier was appointed to coordinate between the emperor and administration. He was called Diwan-e-Vazir-e-Kul and also held the head of finance and revenue system. The head of the army was called Mir Baksh. He recruited the army and its officers. He supervised the intelligence system. The spies of the Mughal Empire were known as Vakyanavis. There was a department called Mir-e-Saman to look after the personal needs of the emperor. He was also the head of government factories. The head of the judiciary was Qazi. Next short note, can we write a note on Mughal architecture? The Mughals established many forts, palaces, gates, mosques and gardens. Babur set up gardens in Agra and Lahore. Sher Shah built a tomb at Sasaram and a mosque at Delhi. Akbar built the fort of Agra and made unique construction at Fatehpur Sikri, 36 km from Agra. These include Buland Darwaza, Salim Chishti Darga, Mosque and Panch Mahal built in memory of his victory over Gujarat. The use of marble increased in construction during the time of Jahangir. The time of Shah Jahan is considered to be the golden age of architecture of the Mughal Empire. He built the Taj Mahal and the Moti Masjid in Agra as well as famous Red Fort in Delhi. Aurangzeb built a tomb of Rabi'ul-Duran, Bibi Ka Maqbara, which bears a striking resemblance to the Taj Mahal in Aurangabad in memory of his wife. Next, write a note on victories of Chhatrapati Shivaji. Chhatrapati Shivaji conquered more than 40 forts to expand the great Maratha kingdom from a small estate. He fought with the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb and Adil Shah of Bijapur Sultanate for a long time and finally achieved victory. When Aurangzeb imprisoned him, he escaped cleverly and fought back and won. He was coronated in 1674 AD at Rajgarh and rose to prominence as a Hindu emperor. Discuss the religious policy of Akbar. Akbar adopted a liberal religious policy towards the Hindus and started social relations with the Rajputs. He was a secular king. He brought together the best elements of all religions and established a sect called Din-e-Ilahi. He opposed child marriages and sati. He abolished pilgrim taxes and banned forced religious conversions. Discuss the reforms done by Sher Shah. Sher Shah was a reformer and a just ruler. He established peace in the kingdom by controlling bandits and robbers. He established a new postal system. He built inns for traders and pilgrims, introduced the currency of the rupee and formed a huge army. He built a long highway, Grand Trunk Road, which connected Bengal and North India. So that's it with the revision part for this chapter. Besides this short note, make sure that you go through the videos or your textbook. Read everything. I have made you underline while explaining. Like, these kind of questions can be asked for your in objective question answers, whether it is blanks, MCQs or true or false. If your concept is clear, you do not have to worry, but still do not get confused. So first of all, make sure that you the short notes are understood and then read the chapter. That's it. After that, just relax and enjoy your day.